So President Joe Biden, or certainly at least his press secretary slash representative who speaks on behalf of him, Jen Psaki, has now actually officially come out for the very, very first time to speak about whether or not he plans to extend the unemployment benefits extension program again after September 2021. Hey everyone, how's it going today? And welcome back to another fourth stimulus check, I guess at this point, unemployment benefits extension update. So the really, really great news, according to what's been going on, according to an interview that he did actually on Actual News, is that he has now officially come out to speak and say that he is open to potentially doing another fourth unemployment benefits extension program after September 2021. Now, I do think it's really, really important to notice is that this does not mean that it's going to happen. Even if he is actually physically open to having it happen, he still has to see if it's even possible to happen, especially because he still also has to gain the approval from a lot of the politicians that are in Congress. And that's something that's really, really interesting that we're really going to talk about. But the really, really great news is that this is really technically the very first time that he's officially come out to at least say something about it. And so the idea is that it's on the table. So it's not, you know, it's still very, very much there. I think the specific word that he specifically or slash his press secretaries said on top of the news is essentially is that they're open to doing it. They don't have plans to do it at this time. However, is that it is on the table and they have to see what ends up happening over the next couple of weeks with all of the stuff that they're currently working on. And is even more true because at this time, now that they've actually partially, they're still in the process of it, but now that they are in the process of trying to approve the infrastructure bill, they will be moving next in order to try to prove or work on the human infrastructure bill. So it's really, really hard to see what's gonna end up happening over the next couple of weeks, but we're going to talk all about that in today's update. So as always, maybe real fast before we begin, maybe consider smashing the like button in light of relatively promising news, because at least it is on the table after all. Consider subscribing and hitting the bell notification for similar videos like this if you guys are interested. Huge thanks if you guys have been here for a while. It's always great to see new and familiar faces, and as always, feel free to comment any questions, thoughts about honestly just really anything or any information that you might have about honestly just really anything at all. So with that being said, let's get this video started right now. So what's been going on is that after coming out for essentially the first time, as mentioned, is that the really, really great news is that it currently now is on the table to potentially do another extension. But as mentioned is that doesn't mean that it's definitely gonna happen. They don't have necessarily set plans to have it happen. However, it's at least there. The one biggest concern and thing that's going on right now is that even though they are open to maybe doing another extension, depending on how the next couple of weeks go, they don't know if they're actually going to logistically be able to do it. And it's actually particularly true because the really great news is that there are definitely a lot of politicians inside of Congress right now that are in support of trying to do another extension, exactly how there are actually technically also a lot of politicians that are open to doing a fourth stimulus check. However, the problem is that there are also some politicians that are also against it. For example, one politician, and you can maybe take a quick guess about who this is, but probably as the same politician that's been, you know, making similar decisions over the last couple of months or even into last year, that is not necessarily in support of it, is Joe Manchin. So Joe Manchin right now is one of the politicians that does not necessarily support trying to do another fourth extension after September 2000, or rather just simply put after Labor Day, because it does end at the very, very beginning of September. So it may be a little bit of a challenge to get people on board. So because of that reason, they don't know if they can actually logistically and actually find an agreement to be able to physically be allowed to extend it once more after September 2021. Now, with that being said, is that it is really, really hard to predict because there are a lot of things going on in the news that's changing very fast. For example, with the Delta cases, which we'll touch up on just in a little bit. But the big thing is that because information is happening very, very fast, you never know how it's going to go. It's exactly the same story with what happened with the second stimulus check, the third stimulus check, how sometimes they would make a decision and then suddenly they would just turn and reverse course that the very, very last minute. So you really, really never know about how they're going to do things. But the big thing is that you also never know is because it is very, very possible that President Biden or even individual states can potentially try to step in to do something special for their own specific state, or in Biden's case, to try to do some kind of executive order. This is actually a huge nostalgia now that you think about it, or now that we think about it, to what happened last year with Trump when he tried to briefly extend the unemployment program, if you guys remember, through the LWA program back all the way in, I believe, around September 2020. If you guys remember, is that essentially the recap is that when unemployment ended, maybe comment if you guys remember or have been here since that long, because it has been a crazy enough to think almost 1 year, and I know some people have been there ever since that time. But the idea is that in that current time period when unemployment originally ended, the first stimulus package, remember how Donald Trump signed an executive order and he was able to extend the unemployment program by another 6 weeks. Of course, there are a lot of limitations to it. That's why he wasn't able to extend it for the rest of the year. But the idea is that there are definitely ways that they can use their power to maybe do this, or certainly some kind of program to make up for it, which at the end of the day, I think the big thing, what most of us care about, is anything that involves being able to hopefully put extra money inside of our pockets, especially for anyone that's going through some time of particular need. And I think that's the really, really important thing to note about it. And in a lot of ways, there are actually already a lot of programs that have actually sadly already ended or will be set to end also very, very soon. But the great news is that many of those programs actually did manage to get extended. So examples of this is basically, for example, like the eviction ban that was recently just extended, student loan forgiveness, or rather just simply put, student loans waiving the interest rate so that if you happen to have student loans, you don't have to pay the interest rate. So you do still have to pay the student loans, but you just don't have to pay interest on it. They extended that program. They also extended the pandemic EBT. There was a program that if you were able to get onto food stamps, which I highly recommend if you guys haven't done so already, because it is something that we kind of talked about a little bit while a couple of months ago. Essentially is that if you were able to get onto food stamps, they boosted the program so you were able to essentially get extra money. That program, I believe, was also recently officially extended. So you never know, because if they were able to extend the eviction ban, the student loans, the pandemic EBT, it is possible that they can extend the unemployment as well. It is a little bit more difficult because of the logistic and the way this program works compared to a lot of the other programs, but it is definitely something that's on the table and it can happen. And last year, there were many times that people questioned whether it was going to happen or not. Of course, the great news now that we are speaking in the future is that it did happen, but that's why it's something that really is kind of a question mark right now. But at least we know is that there is a potential for it. And all of this is actually very, very true, because keep in mind at this current time period, Delta cases are starting to rise very, very rapidly. And like with anything related to the pandemic, as we've probably seen from last year, exactly like the stock market, is that a lot of these numbers, they go up exponentially. So they kind of scatter and they really, really snowball and build up. And when you're doing anything that involves exponents or snowball effects or the stock market or compound interest, or in this case, just simply put, is pandemic cases, is that we do and we are already actually starting to see a massive tick in cases. I believe we finally officially just started to even see cases of the Lambda variant as well. And on top of that, in a lot of other countries, while in this country we don't have certain variations, thank goodness at this time, there are already a lot of other countries that are already seeing other kinds of variants, such as the Alpha, the Beta, of course we have the Delta, there is the Lambda, there's probably other ones that are, I believe there's even a gamma, but the idea is that there might even be more of other Greek letters that they may be adding down somewhere down the line. So we really, really never know. But the idea is that because they are increasing cases right now, is that there is belief that depending on how these cases go, it may potentially spark a reversal for them to maybe change their mind and give another extension, even if it's very, very briefly, like what happened with Trump for 6 weeks back last year. And we are already actually starting to see many, many states that even just over the last two weeks, that made some kind of policy of some kind, whether this had to do with something related to the vaccine, to mask mandates, to travel restrictions, or travel openness, because there are are some states that decided to open up in order to allow people to come in again, and you're already starting to see governors change their mind. You're already starting to see a lot of people reverse course to try to go the other way. And, you know, all of a sudden, one day they're claiming something about mask mandate. 2 weeks later, they're going to reverse that decision and put it back again. So the idea is that it's just simply put is it's really hard to tell. But the biggest takeaway really is that the great news is that it's at least on the table and they are considering it. There is no plans necessarily put in place, but with the new negotiations for the human infrastructure is that it would not be a surprise, or certainly it's that it's fair to say is that there is a chance and there is potential for it. But essentially, that's pretty much what I really just wanted to cover in today's update. So if you guys found that insightful and haven't done so already, maybe consider smashing the like button, consider subscribing and hitting the bell to join in for similar videos like this. You guys can always decide. Huge thanks if you guys have been here for a while, and as always, feel free to comment any questions, thoughts about honestly just really anything. Always great to say hi to me and familiar faces. So with that being said, thank you guys so much for watching. Stay safe, stay well, and hope to see you guys next time. Thank you guys so much again.